Au, au, au. Hey guys, it's Teresa. Thanks for joining me again on my channel for another video. Today's video is going to be a vanity and desk tour. I want to show you guys how I organize my vanity and my desk because I do use one desk for both of those needs. This is the place that I edit. This is the place that I work. This is the place where I feel I can be most creative. So if you would like to see how I set things up for my vanity and for my desk, and if you may even want some ideas, just keep watching. Here is my desk and vanity area. I got this desk from IKEA. I forget what it's called, but I will link it down below for you guys if you would like to purchase it. And it came with the Alex 5 drawers, which was actually one of the reasons that I actually purchased this desk, because I needed a desk that had a lot of drawer space for storage. And I love the way that this looks. It has like a really slick look. I'm sure you guys have seen the Alex drawers all before. So in those drawers, I keep all of my makeup, and on this side of my desk is the side that I use for my vanity. I have my desk separated into two separate areas. This area to the right is my vanity, and this over to the left is my desk area. So I'm going to start off with my vanity and show you guys the things that I keep on my vanity and the uses that I've come up with for these items, because I do believe in having things to be practical. First off, I have these jars and containers going across my desk like so, and these all serve a purpose. I got the glass containers from the Dollar Tree, and I got the containers that are black and white from Dirt Cheap. I believe the black and white containers were about 20 cents each. So I like to organize my makeup on my vanity in the order that I use it. From left to right, of course, my moisturizer and foundation is first, and then on the very end is an empty container, which is where I put all my dirty brushes. Right now, I don't really have any dirty brushes because I just did brush laundry, even though my blender, which isn't the beauty blender, this is actually the one from Real Techniques. I actually need to go ahead and take that out and clean it because I used it, but everything else is pretty clean because I've been using the beauty blender pretty much every day of late. If we move all the way over further to the right, I have this picture here, and it says dream. This is kind of a reminder to me to keep my dreams alive and to keep striving. Directly behind my vanity, I have a large mirror that I use to get dressed, to do my makeup and my hair and things like that. And I also have the lights that I use while filming. Usually my tripod is actually directly between these two lights, and that's where it stays unless I need to move it somewhere to film something, but I'm using it right now, so it's not there. Now I'm going to move on to the second half of my desk and show you guys the area that I work in. Here is where I do all my editing. I pay bills here. I plan out things here. And this is the area of my desk that usually gets the messiest. So I'm going to go ahead and jump in and show you guys what I have over here. I just have two Vogue magazines. The first Vogue is from September 2012. Which is actually the first Vogue that I ever bought. And then the second Vogue on top of that is from October 1997. This Vogue is actually a collector's item. It has Princess Diana on the cover, and I really did like her a lot, so I really wanted to buy that. I got that from a consignment shop. And I got this little flower here from the Dollar Tree, and I got the vase from the Dollar Tree too. I thought that it would just be a nice little pop of floral to the room, and I really like it. Moving further to the left, I have another picture here in this corner that says life is beautiful. This is another reminder to myself to kind of keep pushing towards my dreams, and it also reminds me that no matter what type of rut I'm in, there are beautiful things in life. And I also have a small Bible here. Even though I do keep the Bible on my phone, sometimes I just want to reach for something that's a hard copy, and I have it there at my desk when I need some motivation and a little bit of strength. And then I have this acrylic case here. I got this case from Target, And in this case, I have a really miniature stapler. I thought that this was like the cutest thing ever, so I had to go ahead and buy that. And then I have my SD cards, and I also have my card reader because my Mac does not have a card reader onto it, so I had to go ahead and purchase a separate card reader. Moving on over to the left of that, I have this acrylic pencil holder. This was actually a gift to me by my older sister. And this is able to hold pencils and pens. And I also have a pair of scissors in here. And I got these sticky notes from Target. And I thought they were really cute because they're black and white, of course. And I just keep extra things in these little drawers. This just pulls out like that. And so in this one, I have my extra staplers. Of course, I have my MacBook over here because this is where I work. And I know it kind of seems like it's a little tight, but I like kind of sitting in this little corner here because it makes me feel kind of cozy and it keeps me focused on what I'm doing, and I don't get really sidetracked when I'm sitting here. And right up above it here, I have a picture of the Eiffel Tower, which is actually one of my places on my bucket list that I want to visit. I got this pink chair from Goodwill, and I believe I only paid $5 for it. And as I was walking out on that same day, I actually saw this pink mirror, and I got that. And that's actually how the pink came into this room. I'm not a fan of pink, but I thought that for $5, and I think this mirror was $3, I could make myself a fan of it. So I bought this pink chair to go into this room because I needed a rolling chair so that I could work more efficiently. This pillow is a pillow that I keep in this chair all the time when I'm not sitting in it. And I thought that this was really, really cute. I really love the design on this pillow. And I believe I paid about $5 for this at a store called Roses. And I thought that it had a really glam look and it fit really perfectly in this room. So I got it. Here's an overview of my vanity and desk area. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed already. And until next time, I will talk to y'all later. Bye.